but when I kind of run into a brick wall, y'all kept breaking that wall down. But when y'all did that, you know, everything just accelerated about 3 or 4 times as fast as it was when I was doing it. But the things that I'm not, that I have no knowledge of, the things that I'm trying to do, don't have no idea what the outcome is. You know, I believe that the outcome is going to be good. I'm just trying to do some things of my own strength instead of just counting on God for those things as well, but that I know, as well as things that I know about. You know, so the unknown has kind of been, you know, it's causing me to,
wait,
it causing my faith to waver a little bit, because I want to make sure it goes well. But, you know, like I said, that the revelation that he gave me, those things, it's totally in his hand. You know, I know it's going to happen. It's happening all the time.
Right.
So I've got to learn to not depend on my own strength and the things that I'm not aware of, that I don't know, the outcome, and let God, you know, put those things in God's hand too, and let him, you know, just do that for me as well.
All right, well, it's a learning process. I think everybody hit the nail on the head that you have to release your desire for God to intervene, God to take over, and to show himself strong. You got to pour out your heart to God, verbalize it. You know, many times we can verbalize it in English to the best of our ability, but many times English can't always fully express the things that need to be released on the inside. And I think that this is the importance of praying beyond your ability, your understanding. And that is the beginning, I believe. And then you can even go beyond praying in the Spirit and to travail. And how many know what travail is? Agonizing in spirit. I think that that's a good way. Bible says when Zion travail, what happens? Okay. Sons and daughters are what? So you pray beyond your what? Your ability. Pray beyond your what? Your ability. And the Bible says that we don't know how we should pray. Anyway, we don't know how to pray that perfect prayer. We don't know how to make that perfect connection in our own strength and our own wisdom. But sometimes you just have to pour out your soul completely to God. I'm going to understand what I'm saying. Pour out your soul to what? To God. Amen. You can do that in travail. How many of you travail? Sometimes, amen, no tongues might come. Right? Just travail. Cry. Weep. Broken. Let God work. Work it out of you. Work it, amen. Let God do his will. And I think that brokenness is a real cardinal virtue. Anybody know what I mean when I say brokenness? Yes. Brokenness is when you get out of the realm of your flesh and you begin to what? Amen. Place yourself completely in the what? Hands of God. Amen. Praise God. How many know that he's able to do exceeding what? Abundantly. Now, all of the great men in the Bible that we preached about, they got that great victory. They were men of what? Prayer. They waited on God, travail. They went, amen. They prayed out of the power of their own ability. And then they began to what? Trust completely in the what? Strength of God. But that's a place that we call a place of what? Brokenness. A place of complete trust. Amen. Complete. Amen. God, if you don't do it, amen, there's nothing I can do. Amen. Now let me just read this, and I'm going to close out with this. This is the first step Okay, God has called and commanded us to be followers of Christ and to be workers together with him. We are to do the things Jesus would do if he were personally upon the earth. However, we cannot accomplish this in our strength and human ability. The first step is to believe that we can. Everybody agree with that? Believe that we can. If we walk as he walked and have the same type of fellowship we had with the Father, and yield to God as he did, and act on the word as he did, we would have the same kind of ministry that he had, a ministry totally dependent on God and the Holy Spirit. Amen. I just put it in a nutshell, but there's a whole lot of little fine and intricate things that you could place into that, and, amen, that caused Jesus, amen, to emerge as a man, anointed of God, who went about doing good, healing all of those that were oppressed of the devil, for God was what? With him. I remember we used to sing this song, to be like Jesus, to be like Jesus, oh how I long to be like him. I'm on this journey from earth to glory, all that I ask to be like him. Amen. To talk like Jesus. You know, they just went on and all. Live like Jesus. Amen. All right, let's all stand. God bless you for coming. And Sister Sharon, she gave me this book. No, I'm just saying. Okay, now unto him that is able to keep us from falling and to present us faultless before his presence with exceeding great joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory, honor, dominion, and power, both now and forever. Everybody said together, praise the Lord. Amen. Amen. Amen.